Look out for chests! Oh my god, what a useful advice.
This game is garbage.
The time has come, my brothers. Soon the magic sphere will open its gates for those of you who today will set out for glory and wealth. Soon those names will be given. Of those who will go to the great Dragonland, the names will be immortalized in stone in the Hall of Fame, along with the names of the greatest who changed our history, like the explosion of a star.
Hate to kill idiots.
Everybody here!
Ayumi, it was to be expected. You're not one to obey the rules of the game, are you?
I'm sorry, Guildmaster, but I will use the sphere now. Sitting and waiting is not my style.
Well, you deserved it. I won't be stopping you.
So yeah, this is Blades of Time.
So remind me why you're doing this?
Because a person who shall remain nameless bought this for me, and
I made it.
I don't like it.
I think that person is nameless because you don't know his or her name.
Oh, I.
The legendary dragon.
I know a thing.
It was an anonymous gift.
Yeah. Yeah, it was. Alright. So, right off the bat, we just get into a really... really easy fight with a really simplistic combat system that... I was gonna tell you right now, this combat system will not get any more complex over the course of the game.
Is it like the God of War, one quick attack and one strong attack that's slower?
Yeah, except that you can't really string combos together, it's just sort of... you mash stuff and... they're just separate attacks. Yeah, here's the compass here. Has two arrows, one points the location of your objective, the other points the location of nearby treasures. Which is really helpful.
That's kind of a neat way to do it.
Instead of
putting a little mini map on your HUD.
Yeah, I agree. It's actually kind of a cool thing. And you know, before they give us any time to get acclimated, they give us a brand new weapon.
Already?
Yep.
That's interesting.
I really hate Ayumi. She's...
You're not playing with a stick, are you? I can tell.
No, I'm not. I did play this entirely with the keyboard and mouse.
Oh my god, why? This really looks like a game you should play with a gamepad. Don't you have a gamepad, an Xbox controller somewhere?
I do, but I didn't feel like using it.
What was that? A ghost?
Yes,
no, that's
it
a big
what?
Yeah.
Is she retarded?
It was a ghost, Ayumi. Just move
At
along.
Least now I can see everything with my own eyes.
Who is she talking to?
She's talking to no one, and she will continue talking to no one forever.
But there are no maps or descriptions available. It's not really surprising. The guild is the most secretive organization in the whole world.
It's like, how can we crowbar this exposition?
In the most clumsy way possible.
So, do we know what the story is so far at this point? Because I haven't been really paying attention.
Really, at this point in the game, you're not supposed to know much of anything.
The guards for the ancient treasures, just like
looks like she's looking for treasure. That's all I got.
Yeah, apparently Ayumi is a treasure hunter, and those people at the beginning that she and her partner were attacking were like the guild of adventurers or
honestly,
something. I can't
I thought
really remember.
I'd find some hints for treasure hunters to follow left here by guild
but basically they have
like marks on the
that
floor
orb
on
she
the
touched
stones.
At the beginning transports her to this place called Dragonland, and she's here in search of treasure.
Ayumi, the
there's your story for right now.
Was here. That's stupid, though. Zero would be really angry with me.
Jesus Christ, who did they get to read those lines? You know, I remember watching... I'll say that after... I'm sure that cutscene is interesting.
Come closer.
Who are you?
I am the spirit of the altar. You are entering Dragonland, stepping on your path for the first time. I am here to assist you.
To assist me? I need to find my partner, Zero.
That is of no importance to me. My duty here is to assist you in gaining power.
What do you mean? I'm here to find the treasure of the Dragon Temple. If you know something relevant, you can assist me with that. Don't waste my time.
I suggest you follow my guidance to survive. Now, that is my first gift to you.
No need for gifts. I don't like to be in debt. What did you do?
We are now connected, and I shall guide you on your path. With my help, you shall be victorious.
Tell me, what is it that you want from me?
To complete the path. The ability I empowered you with enables you to gather the life force of the enemies you defeat. Bring them to my altars, and you shall be rewarded.
Are you out of your mind? I don't need it. Take it back.
My gifts do not force anything upon you. Now, go, and be careful. A great danger awaits you.
Hey, wait! What about the danger? Excellent.
So it wants her to complete...
feeling.
The
I don't
path
like it at all.
With all 7 characters?
No. No, apparently the great treasure of Dragonland lies at the end of the path. But in order to do that, she's got to...
find grandmother's house?
Exactly, yes.
God, it's so hot here. It's unbearable. I hope this path won't lead me to the center of the world.
That's...
if I hadn't come here on my own, I'd have thought that I was in hell right now. Or maybe I am in hell. Oh well, who knows?
Oh well, that's not the voice of a woman who's entering, like, a volcano place.
Oh well, who knows?
What's going
hell,
on?
You know?
Have I stumbled into something again?
Oh, I remember...
No. Damn it. These
stop talking,
places
Ayumi.
Are always full of surprises.
She doesn't stop.
No.
I just want to play something here. I remember watching some cutscenes from X-Blades, and she was more expressive than this. She was also more annoying.
I actually stopped running just to show you that the lava does actually slow down the closer it gets to you.
Move, Ayumi. Keep moving,
but,
don't stop.
Not sure how well that actually came across.
Is it like instant death?
Probably.
Shit! What's going
shit
on? It can't be true. This is me! This doesn't seem funny at all. Everything has... stopped. Even the fire is completely still.
Unbelievable. I've never seen anything like this before. But it's impossible. Zero would laugh if I told him about it.
So you have the power to rewind time. Jesus Christ, get it.
Time has started again. Who's doing that?
You know, I'll be honest. So far, it looks like a decent game. I mean, it looks all right. It could play all right. And if she could just shut the fuck up, it wouldn't be so bad.
It really wouldn't be so bad. I mean, the combat is not terrible.
They're huge. Where did they come from?
There is some like genuinely good art direction around.
Spiders.
But it's just like,
that's what the altar was talking about.
It's just
life force.
Not
I'm draining it.
Ugh.
So far, Ayumi talking all the time is the big no.
Yeah.
But when are we gonna get to the bullshit parts of the game, like the gameplay? Cause you told me there would be bullshit.
Oh, there's bullshit. Not in this, you know, early section.
This place is just like one of those places I saw in an old book about Dragonland. These chests once contained the great treasures of ancient civilizations. But where is it now?
Our group entered Dragonland yesterday, but what I'm looking for is not exactly the same as what the others are. This place is full of unknown plants and animals, and I'm sure that no other naturalist has ever set foot here. That's why I'm here. I know that this land is full of danger, but I'm ready to pay the price for knowledge. I'm going to leave short messages on my way. I hope they will help you, whoever you are.
So yeah, that was one of the notes in the game. There are many of them. I'm not going to sit there and let you listen to all of them, but that was just a short little demo of how annoying they could be.
Is it just about? Is it just like world building?
Yeah, pretty much.
They never contain like clues about how to kill something.
No, yeah, this is not
the
at all.
For sure. It must be
it's
the
purely
switch.
Flavor text.
This battle system is fascinating, because you seem to be doing the same thing over and over.
Yeah, there's really no combos in the game that I know about.
What are they guarding if all the trunks are empty?
You know, it's not like God of War where you can just string together a freeform thing, or even like Ninja Gaiden Black where you actually have a move list. It's basically just two buttons. You have your light attack, which does fast little combos, and you have your heavy attack, which kicks enemies into the air. That's basically it.
So those little lights that come out and go to you, those are experience points or something?
Okay, the experience points, okay. I have no idea why they put experience points in things I break. You never get a counter of how much you have. There's never any thing you can spend it on, like...
But you get... Do you have a counter of experience somewhere?
No. If you do, it's hidden somewhere.
Who the hell are you?
Oh, God, these things are annoying.
Get out of here! Go back to where you came from!
No, but there's no, like, economy of experience points. You'll see later what I mean.
So what are those little things?
Supposedly they're...
putting up these magic walls?
Oh, shut up, Ayumi! God.
That's it? Is it watching me? But why would it try to stop me?
So those things are just... here for the visuals? Maybe there were experience points and they forgot to include them? Or decided to not include them?
I have no idea.
Hey, you found a gun.
Mm-hmm.
This is Devil May Cry now.
Not bad at all.
So yeah, the guns, you know, at one point they are, you know, alright, but you'll see later that they actually do shake up the gameplay in some pretty awful ways.
Awful ways.
Yeah.
Is it making faces at me?
Oh my god, shut up.
So sometimes you have to use the rifle.
Yeah. Yeah, basically, if you're fighting any enemies, which will come later, that are using projectiles, and you're not using the rifle, or any other gun in the game,
out there. I can hear you
breathing. It's just...
Come out.
It's pretty much a recipe for your death, and we're not even gonna listen to this.
So this isn't really like Devil May Cry, where you can just use the guns to, fill the combos.
I think it was originally intended to be something like that, but I don't...
Because it looks like she goes in that aiming pose when she takes the gun, so it wouldn't be easy to make that flow with the rest of the combat system.
No, you really can't make it flow.
You'll never leave me alone, will you?
Yeah, these specific creatures right here are actually some of the more irritating ones in the entire game, simply because they gang up on you and there's really no invincibility frames to take advantage of.
You can't avoid their attacks, they're...
You can avoid their attacks, but if one of them hits you, you're pretty much just...
What disgusting monsters!
Just knocked back and staggered, and then they all dogpile on you.
I didn't agree to that. Zero's missing all the fun. Where the hell is he?
You didn't agree to what? You decided to come here.
I really wish she'd stop talking. Just.
So her companion is named Zero.
Yes.
That was the guy with the nice haircut at the beginning.
Humans.
Yes, it was. The man with the incredibly...
Come on, guys.
Incredibly large muscles and... fancy mohawk.
And we don't ever get to play him.
Well, actually, you can play as him, but only in the special Outbreak game mode.
Oh, we gotta play that!
Oh, yeah. Okay, if anyone out there is unfortunate enough to own this game and wants to play Outbreak with me, you know, drop me a line. And we'll hook that up.
Do you actually have the Outbreak mode? Is it included in the game, or is it some kind of DLC?
It actually is a standard multiplayer mode. No DLC or anything required.
Oh.
The altar again. What can I expect this time?
She says, while being pulled with magic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so the altars are your source of new spells and abilities. Basically, every time you visit an altar, and I...
What's going on?
You know, as I said earlier about
this
how there's no sort
is
of...
your first trial.
Oh my god.
You'll learn how to use your new abilities.
Okay, so, it's every single time you use an altar to get a new spell, you have to go into this little dream world
now?
Here.
Yes.
And learn how to use
right
it.
Now.
Tutorial land.
Yes. But every single time you use an altar... I think regardless of how much quote-unquote experience you actually have, you're gonna get to choose two things. so I don't really know why the experience orbs exist.
I'm assuming they just used to have an experience economy and then they just decided it was dumb and removed it, but they didn't remove the orbs, the graphical effects.
It sounds plausible.
So what's that power you got? You've been putting fires?
That's basically all it is. You just put a little arc of fire out in front of you. The altars
are sources of strength. she's an 8-year-old.
I know.
These might be the corals. I didn't think those flowers were quite normal. I should use them to climb up here.
So the corals are actually a pretty neat gameplay addition, I have to say. Because earlier with the altar, we got a special ability for dashing to objects, which you'll see how that works out. Also, my treasure sense was tingling.
Was there an actual treasure sense, or you just...
You see how your compass glows even when you're not holding it?
That's the treasure sense?
Pretty much. Yeah, so... got a ring that increases the range of our fire magic. And we'll see what we can use these corals here for. After we kill that face.
Well, it involves climbing, I'm assuming.
Mm-hmm.
They seem to be alive. I hope it won't fall down. Wow.
Wow, indeed.
So yeah, that's the main purpose of the floating corals, is just to act as anchor points to launch yourself places. Which is one of the few mechanics in this game that actually works really, really well, and I kind of like.
This button might open that huge gate.
Wait, isn't that where you came from?
Been looking for treasure here for
yep,
so long,
the entire purpose of this was just to go
I guess all of them had more important
push that button so I could open the big
just
gate.
Like I do.
Oh, I got that gate?
Yep.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Where are you all coming from? It's no wonder that the local civilization was doomed to death.
A new phenomenon.
Uh-huh.
A new phenomenon? Giant faces appearing from nowhere?
I have no idea what the note was actually about. I'm just going to assume it's about something interesting. So yeah, the first...
So you told me those don't actually give you experience. Why do you waste your time breaking pots?
Because I have severe OCD and I like breaking things.
To be fair, I do it too, but usually it's in games where the things in pots actually matter.
Yeah.
Nice, this game is violent.
If I ran into a group of tourists here, anything seems possible right now.
You know, she sounds like a tourist guide. And on the right, you can see the giant floating heads shooting their little weird things. Oh, I hope we're not gonna die in this volcano fiery place. I hope this isn't going to the center of the earth.
Yeah, so anyway, there are other humans in Dragonland. And, they have spiffy hats.
You look new to the island. You know, bad timing. Leave me alone, will ya? And get out as fast as you can.
Just leave me alone, okay?
There must be another way. They look like parasites. If I destroy them, I'll be able to use the corals to get to the other side.
You know, I just love how quickly she puts together these plans in her head.
She's very perceptive.
Mm. Oh yeah, by the way, treasure.
Treasure sense again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, oh, yeah, it is glowing.
Mm-hmm.
Just noticed. You can only equip one accessory at a time.
Yeah, one ring, one amulet, life.
I
stuff like
what
that.
What found so special about the flying corals? I like them though.
I like the shiny things.
Wow, there's something down there.
I have no idea what she's talking about.
Maybe the river. The river is shiny, so she's probably got attracted to it.
Yeah, it's a river of lava. I mean, I guess she... Oh, another altar.
The altar! Let's see what I'll get this time.
She sounds so eager to get... Oh, what's my new toy? What did you bring me this year, Santa?
So we get a new spell and the ability to now dash to enemies, which will be helpful against some of the later enemies in the game, but not so much right now.
Do you get so many powers so quickly, or do they just like... It feels like you got a lot. You got like 3 powers already.
This game does not waste a whole lot of time
I can appreciate
playing
that.
Around. They do sort of like gate you off from some of the more powerful stuff, of course, but you know. Oh, we might have 3 basic powers by the end of this first video.
Yeah, you know, so far this doesn't look too bad. I still don't know why this game is bullshit or bad.
Well, if you'll remember, I was saying pretty much the exact same thing.
Yeah, I do remember that.
There is a certain point at which my attitude changed completely, and I hate this game now.
Because, I mean, I've seen X-Blades, and X-Blades, from the get-go, you know it's a shit game. This looks alright.
I wonder what that is.
Have you come? Enter the portal!
Are you the gatekeeper?
It depends on where it leads to, really.
The path has no clear boundaries, and only the portals show the way. This portal is the only way for you.
I'm not following. Is this somehow connected to the treasure of the Dragon Temple?
The path is the treasure of Dragonland, and it ends in the Dragon Temple. This is where you will find your true essence and power. Prepare yourself, for it is time to start your challenge!
So, this is the first boss of the game. I don't remember what his name is, and I don't really care.
Almost killed you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was a clever demo to show off healing in this game.
Yeah, clever demo.
Yeah, totally.
So you don't have regenerating health?
You do regenerate health outside of combat, but in combat, all you have are those three little crosses on top of your health bar. As you can see, I've already used one of them. So, have you figured out this boss yet?
Attack the little things on the side.
Clever.
I have no idea what hit you. It's going a little too fast for me, but maybe it's because I'm not playing it.
He's basically shooting fireballs, and then he stomps the ground and creates a shockwave.
But I just didn't see the fireballs coming.
This boss is kind of boring.
He's also dead.
Oh no, he's not dead yet.
Oh, you have to attack his crotch.
Yeah.
Oh, you almost got it.
Almost. So close.
Is there a difficulty setting in this game?
There is, but the first time you play it, you can only play on normal. And you can only access hard mode by going and revisiting chapters.
Which you're not gonna do.
I'm gonna go ahead and say probably not.
Probably doesn't change anything, does it?
I don't know.
I'm assuming all it changes is that enemies hit harder. That's usually what these games do.
Usually. So yeah, that was the first boss, and for some reason I find
yesterday
lore
we met
very
an
important.
Apparently human.
Fancy seeing you again. Who are you? I am the spirit of the dragon. Thank you for setting me free. I'm deeply indebted to you. And what brings you here? I understand the reason why you are here, and that you'll be needing my assistance. I know this island. I can help you find what you are looking for. If that's the case, have you seen a well-built man somewhere? You must be referring to your partner, Zero. Yes, you know of him? I'm sorry. I just overheard you speaking about him to Alter.
Look at me, I am so very pretty. Eavesdropping on me?
I don't think you can help me. Don't be too hasty. You wouldn't have been able to leave that cave alive without me. You were the one that saved me. What did you do? It will be easier for me to show you, rather than explaining it. So, would you like to open this portal? Sure. Let's give it a shot. So, what do we do? You were given many abilities by Alter, but at the same time, you already had some yourself. You merely need to discover them. First, we will attempt to rewind in time. Now concentrate, and when you see yourself in the past, you will understand.
Oh yeah, this is the main gimmick of the game.
That's right. You can be in several places at once this way. Why am I able to do this? It's because of Dragonland.
We're playing bread in 3D.
It awaits your ancient good. The portal is
you know, I guess so.
Get in, and I'll see you on the other side.
Except not as good.